This is one of the most versatile solar panels that I have had the chance to check out. Welcome to the Hippie Geeks. Let's take a look at the ACOPOWER 200-watt lightweight solar suitcase and show just how versatile this unit is and how thrilled we are that they sent this unit over for us to check out. The first thing we need to look at is the weather resistance of this unit, as it was sitting in my studio when the last hurricane destroyed the roof and inches of rain poured into the structure for hours. You can probably tell by looking at the cardboard, but this box got absolutely soaked, and I am really curious to see what the unit looks like once we get it out of the box. Once the cardboard box is opened up, we can take a look at the carrying case the unit comes in, which is a very solid fabric material. You are going to want to store the solar panel in here when you are not using it, as it will help to protect it, but it also holds the two sides of the suitcase together for easier handling. There is also an integrated pocket to hold cables, which you can see here. The ACOPOWER solar suitcase comes with a pair of cables. The first one is a pair of alligator clips that terminate into an Anderson connector. The other one is an Anderson power cable extension, and we will be taking a look at how to hook these up later in the video, and they are one of the reasons that this unit is so versatile. I am going to set those aside and get the panel out of the case. There are zippers on each side of the carrying handle, and you just unzip them all the way around the back of the unit, which will allow you to open it up and see the panel. The first thing you are going to notice is the ETFE coating that is on there, and that is going to help protect the panels from corrosion and also help with light transmission. These panels are rated with a remarkable 23% conversion efficiency, which is really excellent, especially when it comes to these portable panels. I am going to go ahead and unfold the unit and see just what is on the backside here, as it is pretty interesting and different from what we have looked at before. You can see that each panel has its own metal kickstand that is clipped into the back of the panels for transportation. We will set this up later in the video, but it is nice to see such a robust support system, as it will definitely make it easier to set this up. There are a couple of different connectors on the back here, and the first one is the typical MC4 connector that you would expect to see on any solar panel. You would use this connector if you are going to hook the panel directly into a battery bank or into a charge controller in your existing solar system. Later in the video, we will look at how this hooks into our Agritech Sonic 1200 that we reviewed a little while ago. The other set of cables is coming out of the charge controller, and you would use this if you need to hook the unit up to a car battery like the one that we are using on our outdoor shower, which we will also look at later in the video. If you want to use the panel with its charge controller, you would connect these MC4 connectors into the shorter pair in the upper right, as that will bring the solar power from the panels directly into the charge controller, and then the power will be sent out via the gray Anderson connector that is there. Here is the 20 amp solar charge controller, and it is currently Velcroed to the back of the panels. You can pull it forward to let it swing freely once the unit is set up, which makes it a lot easier to read when in use. You can see where the MC4 connectors connect to the charger at the solar positive and negative terminals, and then that Anderson connector is hooked into the battery positive and negative terminals. Now that we have looked at the connectors, let's see how easy it is to set this panel up. This unit is incredibly compact and lightweight for the amount of power it provides and the versatility of the connections that it comes with. The entire unit is only about 15 pounds and is only about 22 inches by 43 inches folded up, or 44 inches by 43 inches when unfolded. The lightweight and size make it really easy to set up, and once it is unfolded, you just need to flip out both kickstands and set it back into place. Once it is set up, you can see how the cables are all very accessible, though at this point I still have the charge controller Velcroed to the panel. Taking a quick walk around the unit, you can see how compact everything is and how little space it takes up for the amount of power it is providing. Alright, it is the next morning now, and it is time to actually set up the ACOPOWER solar suitcase and use it to charge up the Agritech battery bank. As you can tell from the angle of the sun, this is really early in the morning and the sun has just come up over the mountain, so I am not expecting to be able to get a lot of charging yet, but we will see how it does. It has been sitting outside all night, and you can see the condensation that has formed on the panels. That is another reason that the IP68 waterproof rating is so nice. You don't have to worry about it getting destroyed just because it gets wet. You can see that I have hooked the solar panel directly into the battery bank's own MC4 connector cable, which with this unit means it is connected into the side of it. I will not be leaving the unit like this for long. This is only so that the camera can actually see the screen, so we can tell how much power it is bringing in. When I am done getting the video, it will be set up like this so that it can cool itself properly. I am also going to leave the unit in the shade that the ACOPOWER provides, which will also help to keep it cool. Looking at the screen, you can see that the battery is currently at 57% and is bringing in 111 watts of power, which is actually really great for this time in the morning. Once the sun is fully up in the sky, we will actually be bringing in 201 watts, which is amazing. I wasn't able to get video of that, however, as between the time that I checked on the battery bank and then was able to make it back with the camera, it had gotten to a full charge. That is not super surprising, as it had been set up for a couple of hours, which is all that it needed to finish charging this, but I was happy to see that the solar suitcase was able to put out its full rated wattage. If this battery bank had been completely emptied down to zero, this solar panel would be able to completely top it off with 5 hours of sun, which is just about perfect, as that is what you can expect to see on a mostly sunny day. Next up, I wanted to test out this unit using its charge controller, and I am going to do that with the car battery that has been powering our outdoor shower for the last couple of months. Yes, I know that I shouldn't have the battery directly on the ground, and I will eventually get it moved, but for now it is working here. You can see that I have the alligator clips hooked onto the positive and negative posts on the battery, which then goes over to the solar panel and its charge controller. My camera battery actually died right then, and the battery was sitting right at 12.5 volts when I hooked this up. The screen on the charge controller is now showing where it is at after a little while, which has made it all the way up to 13.2 volts. You can see that I have the MC4 connectors from the charge controller hooked into the panel's MC4 connectors, and that is what allows the charging magic to happen here. Going back the other direction, you can see the Anderson extension cord going from the charge controller to the alligator clips and into the car battery. The thing about something like this is that you could actually use this unit to recharge your car's battery if you end up draining it when you are camping. There have been several times over the years when I have run the car's lights or radio too long and needed to get a jump to leave the campground. With this unit, you could just keep the battery charged during the day and never have to worry about a dead battery. It is really easy to change the battery setting on here as well, and all you need to do is hold down the bottom button for a couple of seconds until the screen starts to blink, and then you just keep hitting the button to cycle through all of the options that you can see on the top of the screen. I am going to leave it on AGM, however, as that is the kind of battery I currently have it hooked up to. There is more information that you can cycle through as well, and you do that by using the top button. Initially, the screen will show you what the current volt reading is for your battery, which for me currently is 13.1 volts. Next up are the amps that are currently being brought into the battery, and as it is very cloudy, we are only getting about 1 amp brought in, which is about 12 watts. Here is a look at it a bit later in the day, and the sun is out a bit more, and we are seeing 5 amps coming in, or about 60 watts, which is actually pretty good. The place that I have this located at the moment is also partially shaded by some trees, and it is impressive that there is any power making it into the battery at all. I have been using this unit for a few days now, and I love its versatility. This panel is a perfect match for the solar generator that I have, and has been doing a fantastic job recharging it every day. It is super stable and has not flipped over or moved at all in the breezy weather that we have had this week, and the 23% efficiency means that we are making the most out of every hour of daylight that we get. The fact that it can be used to charge up a normal car battery as well has guaranteed that I will be bringing this on any future camping trips. Yes, you can actually go camping here on the Big Island, and bringing it will make sure that my car battery never leaves me stranded if I have the lights on too much. One of the other nice things is that with its lightweight and compact size, both Noah and Lindsay are able to set this up as well, which isn't possible with some of the larger panels that we have dealt with, as there is no way they are able to carry around that kind of weight. I will definitely be checking in again in a few months to talk about how this panel has been working out for us, but for now I am thrilled that ACOPOWER sent this unit over for us to take a look at. There is one last thing that we need to talk about though, and that is cost. Looking at the ACOPOWER website right now, the current price is $350, which is a very solid price for what you are getting here. A super solid, lightweight, and easy to set up 200 watt suitcase solar panel that has its own 20 amp charge controller. The flexibility of it is truly not something that I have ever seen in a solar panel before, and the performance levels that I have seen so far are really impressive. A big thank you to ACOPOWER for sending us their 200-watt portable solar panel kit, and if you want to check out this unit for yourself, make sure to click on the link to their website in the video description down below.